बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। आई एम हसनैन अली फ्रॉम चांदबाग स्कूल, ग्रेड 12 एंड 13 केमिस्ट्री टीचर। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आवर वीडियो इज रिलेटेड टू बोरहेबर साइकिल। अंडरस्टैंडिंग इज क्वेश्चन दैट इज आस्क्ड रिलेवेंट टू बोरहेबर साइकिल विद इन द पेपर 4 ऑफ कोर्स कोड 9701 केमिस्ट्री। द क्वेश्चन वॉज ड्रॉ बोरहेबर साइकिल फॉर मैग्नीशियम ऑक्साइड एंड कैलकुलेट द लैटिस एनर्जी ऑफ मैग्नीशियम ऑक्साइड। So for the development of the Born-Haber cycle, you can see here I have developed the Born-Haber cycle. There are two types of arrows within the diagram. That one is blue arrow that is depicting the direct path, while the yellow arrows are depicting the indirect path. So for the purpose of the direct path, in that case magnesium and oxygen are reacting together to form magnesium oxide, and the enthalpy change for this step is known as enthalpy of formation of magnesium oxide, that would be given by the examiner. While for the indirect path, the first step was the conversion of magnesium solid to magnesium gaseous. For that we would be needing the enthalpy of atomization of magnesium. In the indirect path, the second step was the conversion of the oxygen to oxygen gaseous atoms. For that purpose we would be needing the enthalpy of atomization of oxygen, and that could be seen through the data booklet. Examiner would not be giving this value of the atomization enthalpy of the oxygen, would not be given by the examiner. In the third step, this was the primarily conversion of the magnesium to magnesium 2 positive ion in gaseous form. So we would be needing the first ionization energy and the second ionization energy of magnesium in this step. While in the fourth step, it was the conversion of oxygen to oxide ion, that is O2 negative ion in gaseous form. For that purpose we would be needing the first electron affinity and second electron affinity of oxygen. All these steps are shown in an ascending order towards the upward direction, which means that energetically these all processes are endothermic. When the magnesium 2 positive ion and oxygen 2 negative ion are formed in gaseous form, they react to form magnesium oxide via indirect path, and for this purpose the enthalpy change that takes place, that it is known as delta H lattice or lattice energy of magnesium oxide. So we have drawn the whole Born-Haber cycle. We are able to attain 6 marks relevant to this development of the Born-Haber cycle of magnesium oxide. Now for the calculation purpose, we would be equating the direct path to the indirect path. The direct path was the enthalpy of formation of magnesium oxide, while the indirect path contained atomization enthalpy of magnesium, atomization enthalpy of oxygen, first ionization energy of magnesium, second ionization energy of magnesium, first electron affinity of oxygen, second electron affinity of oxygen, plus lattice energy of magnesium oxide. So these all enthalpies of the indirect path are summed up. Here you can see I have written in summed up form the enthalpies in the indirect route. So examiner would be giving us the value of enthalpy of formation of magnesium oxide. The enthalpy of atomization of magnesium is also given, while the enthalpy of atomization of oxygen is to be taken from the data booklet of the bond energy subtopic. In the data booklet you can calculate the enthalpy of atomization of oxygen from there. Then we would be needing the magnesium's first ionization energy and second ionization energy, that could also be taken from the data booklet. In this case the first ionization energy of magnesium is 738 kilojoule per mole, while the second ionization energy of magnesium is 1450 kilojoule per mole. While the electron affinities of oxygen, the first and second one, are given by the examiner, here are the values. The first electron affinity of oxygen is -141 kilojoule per mole. The second electron affinity of oxygen is 844 kilojoule per mole. While we have to calculate the lattice enthalpy of magnesium oxide. So students, by working out and calculating the lattice enthalpy of magnesium oxide, we are able to attain a value that is -3890 kilojoule per mole. So this further part of calculation would be giving you further 2 marks. You are able to attain 2 further marks and get about nearly 8 marks by attempting this question. Students, hopefully you have found this video useful. Take care of yourself. Allah Hafiz.